So as such, realize that those are points that are relatively easy to grasp. And now a word on this.
So we're sort of in the middle of week two now. We've had a couple of lectures, and now we're going to deliberately take a couple of minutes to talk about academic honesty. What motivates this sort of conversation at this sort of depth right now?
Yeah, you know, I mean, this is something we, and I think a lot of CS courses, if not courses more generally, experience, which is some degree of academic dishonesty in the class, which in our case typically takes the form of students in the class collaborating unduly, going beyond the scope of what's allowed by CS50's syllabus, or worse, Googling around and finding some online solution or GitHub repo that has solutions in it and proactively seeking out answers to problems. I mean, per the syllabus, the course is pretty pretty generous, I think, in terms of the allowances, because we want students to be adopting practices now that they're going to use in the real world, which is looking at Stack Overflow and using Google more generally to find little tidbits, little ingredients that they can weave into their own solutions.
Right.
But that's the distinction, like their own solutions. And Googling, you know, CS50 Mario Pyramid Enter and looking for outright solutions, like that's clearly crossing a line. And so what we're trying to do in this week two of the class is send a message of clarity as to where those lines are and remind students to not just skim, but to actually read the academic honesty policy in the syllabus and appreciate where those lines are and be comfortable within them. But then honestly, we also share some statistics and some data and behind the curtains of what we do. And we use over the years a number of tools, Moss from Stanford, eTector from Princeton, which are web-based tools that allow us to analyze and cross-compare all submissions from this year, as well as against like the past 9 years of submissions, which we certainly archive, so as to look for statistically unlikely similarities among students' work, at which point we don't just summarily then discipline students if we see matches, whether outright or pretty close matches, then human eyes come in. And
right.
So like you and I and some of the course's senior staff will iteratively go through it, trying to get to a place of emotional comfort that, yeah,
this feels like it's kind of, yeah.
And it's time for us to act.
Now, are tools like Moss and eTector things that are available for others to use as well?
Yeah, they are. In both of those cases, they can email the faculty who created the software and ask for accounts with which to use it. But I think it's the right thing to do, right? You want to be fair to so many of the other students who are staying well within those constraints and make clear, I think, reputationally that the course takes this seriously and that we do look for it and we do pursue it if there's an issue so that everyone can feel comfortable that everyone's being treated the same.
It's a particularly fine line to have to toe, though, especially in a CS class where collaboration is encouraged and collaboration is what you're going to see in the real world. And
it's hard to have this conversation now with an 8-foot duck on the stage.
Okay.
But note to self for next year, take the duck off the stage first.
But I think it's a really important one to have, and I think it's good to normalize students' expectations. And and then this, of course, this regret clause was something we introduced a couple years ago.
Yeah, and this was pretty contentious early on because we're the only course that does something like this, or at least certainly quite so visibly. But this was deliberate. I mean, we have years' worth of data, and we know that for many of the cases of academic dishonesty that come forward, it really is late night poor decisions. Students are super stressed, PSET, whether ours or someone else's, is due the next day. They're under a time crunch. They've got lots going on. There might be issues of physical health, mental health, or interpersonal issues, or whatever the case may be. And they make a bad decision. And up until just a couple of years ago when we rolled out this regret clause, which is really just one extra sentence in the course's syllabus that encourages students within 72 hours to come forward to me or the course's heads and just own up to a poor decision and tell us what they did and how it came to pass, at which point we commit to handling the case internally. So I'll handle it with the student directly. We will take some punitive action, typically zeroing the problem or the problem set in question, but then we literally and quite verbally make clear that we'll consider the matter now behind us,
right,
assuming this is the first such instance thereof, and we don't escalate it to the university itself, where it would be handled typically much more harshly and much more distantly from the class.
Mm-hmm.
And this has been huge, because I think for our case, and I think in general, you wake up after having gone to sleep at 4 a.m., 5 a.m., and you realize, oh my God, what did I do? And you've never before in CS50 had an outlet with which to solve that. I mean, I think it's too much to ask and unlikely to expect a student to, on their own, knowing how severe the outcomes could be, to just proactively own up to it, unless you create a relatively safe space in which they can come forward that doesn't excuse the behavior. It still handles it and handles it pretty firmly internally, but doesn't mean the end of their academic year
right,
in the class itself. And I think it's actually really a teachable moment. And indeed, we've done, this is the third year in which we've had the so-called regret clause. And the first 2 years, we had some 20 or so students come forward and had 20 heart-to-heart conversations with me. And in a few cases, it led to a revelation of some personal issues that we were then, with the student's blessing, involved their resident advisors and so forth. So they got the right help. And so it was kind of a nice...
It's a nice side effect of doing something like this, is to be able to surface these kinds of issues and help students in other ways than just being an educator.
Yeah, and I think by far the healthier and more appropriate outcome than 3 months later, some verdict being handed down, that certainly I think is sensitive to some of those issues, but it's far too distant, I think, from the act in question. So I think the fact that we've given students a window, and it's somewhat arbitrary, but 72 hours feels like enough time for them to catch up on some sleep, to do some reflection without being rushed into it, but still to own up within a reasonable amount of time for us to come forward and deal with it. So overall, hands down, I wish every course everywhere did something like this.